Welcome back, everybody. Our second day of that inner journey, that introspective journey using yin yoga postures to allow that silence to really open up what's happening inside on our mental level, emotional level, the mind that's constantly going in circles or moving distracted from thought to thought, sensations in the body, which can also bring up discomfort on a physical level, also on a mental level. Making sure that we're never in any kind of pain as we do the postures, but having that level of stretch sensation where we do feel like it's targeting deeper into the bodies, and that longer time, that 3 to 5 minutes of holding the posture, will allow that sensation to arise even more. So observing that as we go. Awesome. First posture today, Seiza. We're tucking our toes, either sitting back on the heels, maybe you're having a block underneath the heels and the tail, or even a cushion to be higher. If it gets too intense at any point, leaning forward. Hands on the knees. Take a deep breath in. Sigh it out. Just observing the body sensations. And just gently leaning forward, release the toes. You can gently sit back on the feet if that feels appropriate. Maybe lifting one knee at a time, or both. It's a bit of a counter stretch. When you come into dragon, if you have bolsters or blocks, however you like to do these shapes, please grab the appropriate props. Right leg forward, coming into dragon, so that left leg's the target area. You can tuck the back toe. If you're up dragon, maybe twisted dragon for those that like that, or even down dragon. Deep breath in wherever you're at. Sigh it out. Just allow yourself to be in this shape. Deep breath in and out. Gently push back using that front leg and slowly, cautiously bring that leg we've just stretched forward. Coming into dragon, focusing, targeting that back leg, the back hip, tucking that toe, even squeezing the glutes just to feel that out. A nice deep breath in and out. Tuning into the body, the breath sensation, observing. Deep breath in, sigh the breath out. Pushing back, we'll come down to Sphinx, either on elbows on the floor. If you've got a bolster or blocks, you're welcome to use that. Coming down into this back bend, extension of the spine. Soften the glutes, maybe you're tucking the back of the toes. Deep breath in and out. Allow yourself to be still. Deep breath in and out. As you exhale, just roll flat onto the floor. Release down, just for a few breaths. Crocodile position. We're going to come into our butterfly arm stretch very soon. So the butterfly arm, either a nice wide V or a bent elbow, fingers facing forward, looking the opposite way. And you're going to roll over onto that right hip, head is on the floor. So the right arm's out to the side. That top leg maybe can go back, resting on the floor like a kickstand. We're here for 2 minutes, shorter time because the shoulders are less dense than the legs. So breathing into this right rib cage, channeling that energy, that life force, oxygen into that right lung, especially. And then just slowly coming down, laying flat on the belly. We're going to do left side. Left arm out to the side. Right hand's pushing down. Left ears to the floor. Rolling over. Making sure that left shoulder joint, pec muscle, biceps, the target area. Rest the head. Breathing here. Deep breath in and out. As you exhale, just rolling flat for a moment. You can rest the head on the fingers interlaced, forehead resting on fingers. And then just slowly sitting yourself up. We're going to work with caterpillar. Both legs out in front. Hamstring stretch. Just folding forward. Just getting into this full caterpillar with both legs out in front. Knees can soften if they need. Even maybe arms underneath. Feeling it through hamstrings, maybe the lower back. Deep breath in and out. Just letting gravity work as it gently pulls and stresses, creating tension in the back line of the body. Take a nice deep breath in. Sigh the breath out. And slowly roll back up with your in-breath. We'll do our supine twist. So laying back, whatever combination you'd like. So right over left for me, I enjoy this one going out to the right. If you want to just have knees together, just rocking out to the right as well. Aiming to get a twist. And arms can be out in that T shape or having the elbows bent. Deep breath in and out.
And nice deep breath in. Sigh the breath out. Gently uncross the legs if they are. Bring them back to center. And just moving into the other side. So for me, it's going to be left over right. And dropping out to the left. Turning the head the opposite way. And just letting yourself hold the shape. Be in the body, in the breath, observing what arises without judgment or criticism. Nice deep breath in and out. Slowly come out of the shape. Moving into Shavasana, final rest, final relaxation. Settling down, closing the eyes, even placing something on the eyes to soften the light. Deep breath in and out. Surrendering, letting go. Allowing the nervous system to reboot.
just gently, very gently, just returning awareness to the physical body. Breath is deepening, hands, the feet are moving, fingers and toes. Lengthen the arms above your head, roll to one side, rest in that recovery or roll both ways, and gently coming back up to a seat. Hands in prayer at the heart, that final respect for self, for each other. Bowing the head, notice what you notice. Deep breath in and cleansing breath out. Inhale for Om. Of energy, channeling that at the eyebrow center, touching the thumbs there for clear thoughts, lips for clear speech, heart space, that love for self, each other, and the teachings. Thanks everybody. See you tomorrow.